Welcome to this third class of fourth class of Kalgar. And today I will present to you a very simple stuff for timing events. I have made a list of it, made some years when event can happen, and it is threefold. Right, I have done all the hard work, you just have to apply it. Now, how does it go? I will give you some years per Rashi. And I will tell you which planet are supposed to get activated at these years. What you have to do is you have to check the planet in the horoscope. And it gives you the result. That's pretty simple, right? You can also use divisional charts for it. I will personally recommend the uses of D1, D3, and D9 for it. Right, if you go by my understanding, D3 is the most important chart. So let's start with it. I will take it randomly. Right, so let's start with the first Lagna, Aries. Aries ascendant gets activated at the age of 20 and 26, 20, 26 and 33. And when Aries gets activated at 20, 26 and 33, it activates the position of Mars and Sun. Now this works two way. It works for the person with Aries Lagna. This works for the person having Moon in Aries. This works for the person having Sun in Aries. And this also works for the person having maximum planets in Aries. Now many a times you will find a chart having equal number of planets in 2-3 Rashis also. At that point of time, you can take all the 2-3 Rashis. So it is for Aries Lagna, Aries Moon, Aries Sun and maximum planets in Aries. For an example, I have 3 planets in Capricorn and all other Rashi have either 2 planets or a single planet. So I also have to see the results for Capricorn. This way. So Aries, at the age of 20, 26 and 33, Mars and Sun are activated. At the age of 45, 50 and 55, Saturn and Rahu are activated. At the age of 13, in the first year and in the seventh year, Mars and Sun are activated. In the third year, in the 12th year, in the fifth year and the 16th year, Moon and Sun are activated. In the 32nd year and the 8th year, Saturn and Rahu are activated. In the 25th year, Jupiter is activated. On the 4th and the 8th year, Venus is activated. And on the 3rd, 12th and 24th year of life, Rahu, Saturn, Moon, Sun, Mars, Jupiter, all these planets are activated. So basically this particular time, you know, this the age of 3, 12 and 24, when Rahu, Saturn, Moon, Sun, Mars, Jupiter, all the 6 planets are activated. This is generally a time with a lot of events in life, life-changing times, right? The age of 3, 12 and 24 for an Aries person, right? Now, sometimes like in this Aries table, you don't find the activation of say a certain, though that I have written about the activation of all of the planets. But for some Lagna, you will find that in some Lagna, Venus is not getting activated at all. In that scenario, the result of Venus will be felt through the activation of the planet who is either conjoining Venus or aspecting Venus or the Navamsha Lord of Venus or the Rashi Lord of Venus, right? This is how you are supposed to do it. I will take it randomly, right? Because a small chunk of it I'm going to put on YouTube. Right, so I don't want the complete all the Rashis to be there, all the Rashis and all the planets to be there, and I will be teaching you all the Rashis and all the planets. That is pretty simple. By the end of the class, I will take some examples also. Right. Now let's take one more Lagna randomly, one more Rashi random. You choose.
Sir, Aquarius.
Aquarius, okay. So Aquarius. Aquarius activates multiple times by the earth. at the age of 2, at the age of 8, at the age of 16, at the age of 22, at the age of 40, at the age of 50, and at the age of 60, Saturn, Rahu, Mars, and Sun are activated. At the age of 24, Saturn and Rahu are activated. At the age of 2, age of 4, age of 9, age of 12, Moon, Venus, Mars, Sun, all four of them are activated. In the first year, Saturn, Rahu, Mars, Sun, all four of them are activated. At the 32nd and the 19th year, only Saturn is activated. On the 5th and the 6th year, Saturn and Rahu are activated. In the 15th year, Mars and Sun. 12th year, Moon and Venus. 11th year, once again, Moon and Venus. 16th year, only Venus. 21st year, Saturn and Rahu. 25th year, Mercury. 37th year, Sun and Mars. 11th year, 22nd year, and 33rd year, Mars, Rahu, Mercury, and Ketu are activated. And in the 66th and 44th year, Mercury, Saturn, Moon, Venus, Jupiter, Sun, Rahu, Mars, Ketu, all of the planets. The year 66 and the year 44 is the one of the most life-changing, the course of life-changing stuff for Aquarius person, right? You go through the recordings later on and note them down. Right, so that is your department. Okay. Now, I will give you a few examples, right? Just a few things. I will come to the chart later on, charts later on by the end of the session. See, these years, you will see generally it activates malefics only. It doesn't activate benefics much. Maximum time, it indicates malefics only. If you are well accustomed with the basics of astrology, you will know that only malefics give huge results in life. Benefics don't give. See, benefics, the result given by benefic is something that comes in a transition naturally in life. It is not something which is very, you know, very disturbing. The influence of malefics are very disturbing. That's why benefic planets are taken as samagrahas, who make things happen, you know, like in the natural flow. Benefic planets. Malefics are vishamagraha. They stop, change, or disturb the course of life for something to happen. How do you understand it? If the seventh house is having benefics, etc., you know, benefic lord in the seventh house, benefic planet in the seventh house, you remain in your normal lifestyle and then one day meet a lady, you fall in love with her, get married. It is that simple. But when malefics influence the seventh house, malefics are the lord of the seventh house, you go through a crisis. There is a difficult time, there is a difficult phase. At that time, you start interacting with people and then your spouse comes as a savior. Right? They save you, they guide you, and then you fall in love and then you get married. So when malefics have to make a result happen, it actually disrupts the flow of life. All right? So this is how it goes. Now, taking a random planet, because today is Wednesday, let me take Mercury. Now Mercury. Now there are two lists for planet. First, when Mercury is activated as a Karaka. Second, when Mercury is activated as a house lord. Mm-hmm. And in this list too, there is a time when the benefic result of Mercury as a Karaka will come. And there is a time where malefic result of Mercury as a Karaka will come. Okay. The same with the house lordship also. There's a time where benefic result of Mercury as a house lord will come, and there's a time when a malefic result of Mercury as a house lord will come. Now, see, this is very important. Like if you take it to the karma sphere, suppose you get married at an age when the negative influence of, sun is activated. It means that that in marital life, because you got married at a time when the negative result of sun is activated, right? That means the spouse that you are getting is because of the papa karma or the bad works you have done in the previous life related to sun. That is certainly indicated in the horoscope. Right? How to see the basic karma in the horoscope? It is pretty simple. 11th house indicates gain of money. And if there is a malefic in the 11th house, you have obstructed someone's gain of money. That is the certain problem. If the planet is good, exalted, own Rashi, Mula Trikona, Vargottam, etc. In that scenario, you have helped someone gain an income. So that indicates a good karma. Right? Powerful planet, benefic planet, good karma. Malefic planet, afflicted planet, bad karma. And you simply go with the house, right? If the planet is in the 11th house, you know you have created a problem related to the 11th house. And the solution also comes through the 11th house, right? So if you're struggling with the malefic in the 11th house, that means that you have obstructed someone's flow of money in the previous life, right? It is what it means, because it is a malefic. So to remedy it, you help someone get a job. You use your contact, you use your powers and make the person get a job. You do this remedy and the result will be in front of you. And then at that day, you will realize the importance of what I am saying. Right? There is a separate remedy. If you have treated your wife bad in the previous life, that is indicated through an afflicted Jupiter or a malefic in the 7th house. What you have to do is in this life, you have to treat your wife good, right? An eye for an eye, that's pretty simple, right? So this is the basic structure of karma that I just told you. The karma is complex, of course, right? So we are doing one more webinar on the karma of the soul, etc. So that you can, right? However, my point is pretty clear, right? This is the first thing. This is understood, you know, how do you identify the karma? So the karma result of the planet is getting activated when a particular event is happening at a point of time. Okay. Now, suppose you get married today. Now you don't know how it is going to be, right? See, this is the importance of the thing that I'm teaching. You get married today. Now you don't know what is in the store. You check the table and you see which planet is negatively and which planet is positively activating right now. The planet which is negatively activating at this point of time, you are going to have challenges related to that planet in your marital life. And the planet who is positively activated today, you are going to have blessings related to that planet, right? So this way it needs to be understood. You can already know what is in the store for you. And how to remedy it, that I have just told you. Coming back to my topic. So taking Mercury as a Karaka. Mercury as a Karaka gives his good result as the age of 30, at the age of 42, at the age of 18, at the age of 54, at the age of 78, and at the age of 66. Mercury as a Karaka gives bad result at the age of 24, 84, 72, 60, 48, and 46. Right? So Mercury is the Karaka for education, right? And you have an afflicted Mercury. Suppose, or even if you don't have an afflicted Mercury, it doesn't matter. So Mercury is the Karaka for education. And suppose you have a bad Mercury, then at the age of 24, because that is when Mercury is negatively activated, he will make you do some intellectual mistakes or do some mistakes in your education area, which will lead you to a bad result, right? Because bad result arises because of bad karma. Is this clear? So if you have a negative Mercury, most probably at the age of 24, either you are going to take a break from the education or you are going to stop pursuing your education. And that will be a detrimental result at that point of time, which will impact the course of life. So if you have a negative Mercury, and if you leave your studies at the age of 24, you will never be able to restart it again, or you will never be able to complete it again, because it is negatively affecting, right? Mercury as a Karaka is negatively working at that point of time, at the age of 24, right? This point is clear. There's no confusion about this thing. Good. Now, planet as a house lord. For house lord, I will take this. This is Venus aura. Okay. Venus as a house lord activate himself negatively at the age of 30, at the age of 42, at the age of 66, at the age of 54, at the age of 18, and at the age of 78. And Venus as a house lord activate himself negatively at the age of 24, 72, 60, 84, 48, and 36. Now suppose Venus is the lord of the fourth house, which is negatively situated in your horoscope, and he is going to give you bad result at the age of 24. So if you leave your home at the age of 24, if you purchase a property at the age of 24, or if you do anything related to the fourth house at the age of 24, it is the challenges, the obstacles, the hurdles that you will face will be related to the negative results of Venus. You getting my point? So the challenges of Venus are there. If Venus is the fourth lord afflicted, if the Venus is not afflicted, he is not going to activate himself negatively at the age of 24, right? That is pretty simple. If he is not negative, he will not activate himself in a negative way. But it is very rare that a planet is not negative. Every planet is, some place is positive. For some things it is positive, for some things it is negative. Take an example. Suppose Venus is the fourth lord situated in the second house. House position is good. But in the second house, it is afflicted by Mars. So aspect is bad. Aspected by Mars or conjoined by Mars. So you know at the age of 24, if you purchase a property, Venus as the fourth lord, the negative result of Mars aspecting over it will be activated. And this property will incur a lot of fights. Mars, specifically fight between brothers or family members. This is what Mars do. And this comes as a bad result of Venus. So what you want, what you are going to support, you are going to support Venus to come out of this bad karma. What you have to do is you have to take a huge amount of money and donate it to the temple. This is the karmic remedy for the second house. Huge amount of money donating to temple, specifically jewelry. This is the major remedy for the second house. Right? Make a gold chain and donate it to a Devi temple because it is Venus. This particular way it works, right? And list I have made very simple for you, right? You just note down the list. You see which age the person is running, which planet is negatively activating, positively activating. As a house lord, as a Karaka, you can also see when the Rashi is positively or negatively influencing. And then you get the result in your hand, right? This is simple. Like for an example, I want to show you an example. Just a second. For an example, see, I don't set up an example. That is my specialty. You know, I will never set up an example to present in the class. I will take an example then and there. Because if I set an example before, what is the use of technique? Then you cannot getting my point. So see, Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn Monroe got married for the first time in, I think, 42. Marilyn Monroe gets married at the age of 1942. And she was born in 1926. It was the age of 16 running for Monroe. Right, you can see her chart in front of you now. It was the age of 16 running for her. Now, you know what? At the age of 16, the negative result of Mars is activated. Mars as a house lord. The negative result of Mars is activated at the age of 16. Okay. You get my point? Negative result of Mars as a house lord is activated at the age of 16. I will teach this to you when I come to the Mars section. Now you can see this Mars is the lord of the 10th house, which indicates karma. and lord of the fifth house, which indicates children, right? Mars is the lord of the 10th house and the fifth house. 10th house indicates karma. It is a negative karma which is activated right now.
South Indian chart as well, sir.
Okay. It is a negative karma which is in work right now. And secondarily, see, first house indicates the complete childhood. Fifth house indicates the complete young age. Ninth house indicates the complete old age. So this karma, this activation of Mars, because Mars is also the fifth lord, and the fifth lord is getting negatively activated. That means this karma, Mars is the 10th lord, this negative manifestation of karma will destroy the young age completely because of the fifth lord. Got it? Let's see which karaka is getting activated now. In the karaka, Mars, then Mars is also activated as a negative karaka at this point of time, by the way. The negative influence of Mars as a karaka is also activated. Right? And the negative influence of Mars as a karaka is also activated. Mars as a karaka indicates fights and tussle. And that is negatively activated. So there was a lot of fights and tussles in the marriage. Right? Are you getting my point or not getting my point? Is it clear?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Sir, I joined late.
Okay.
Sorry if I'm misunderstanding. आपने मार्स को कारका क्यों लिया मैरिज का?
मैंने मार्स को लड़ाई का कारका लिया मैरिज का।
हाँ जी, हाँ जी, लेकिन सर मैरिज के साथ कैसे रिलेट कर रहे हैं इसको?
मैं ये कह रहा हूँ कि एक एज में एक प्लैनेट नेगेटिव या पॉजिटिवली अफ्लिक्टेड होता है। उस इवेंट पे आप जो भी कर्म करते हो उस कर्म में वो नेगेटिवली या पॉजिटिवली होता है। अब उसने शादी कर ली और वहां पर मार्स नेगेटिवली एक्टिवेटेड है, तो बेसिकली उसको शादी नहीं करनी चाहिए। यूस एज में शादी करेगी तो मार्स नेगेटिवली एक्टिवेट होगा। आप क्लास में लेट आई हैं, आप रिकॉर्डिंग पूरा देखना है।
ओके ओके सर, थैंक यू।
सी इज अ कैंसर लगना, ओके? एंड व्हेन आई कम टू द लिस्ट ऑफ कैंसर, व्हेन आई कम टू द कैंसर लगना, आई विल टेल यू दैट एट द एज ऑफ 16 सन मून राहु एंड वीनस आर एक्टिव। Sun, Moon, Rahu and Venus are activated. You see, Moon is in the 7th house. It was marriage. Venus is in the 10th house. It was a karma. And in the 10th house, it is afflicted by Saturn. Certainly a bad karma. And Sun is in the 11th house. This will also give her money as indicated. And it also activates the result of Rahu that is in the 12th house. So marriage, loss, karma and gain. All of them were there. Right? You understand it? What I want to make you understand? Do you got it? Just a sec. So for a cancer lagna, as I told you, see this lagna based list, I will repeat it once again. The lagna based list, right? For cancer lagna at the age of 16, moon, Venus, Rahu, sun is activated. You actually use for timing it. So for Marilyn Monroe, moon is in the 7th house. So marriage is there. Moon is in the 10th house, right? So 10th house basically indicates a karma, right? So karma is there. Sun is in the 11th house that also have to do something with income, and Rahu is in the 12th house that also have to do something with the loss. Now only for Marilyn Monroe, if you look at her chart, these planets are subsequently situated in the 11th house, 10th house, 7th house and 12th house, which indicates gain of marriage as a karma and then fructifying in loss. Right? Just connecting the dots and making a prediction. Right. So for timing the event, you have to go for the ages I have given for the Rashi. And see, because when we do something, it is very rare. Like it is generally when we do something, it is very rare that we consult an astrologer or a horoscope. Me as an astrologer, if I tell you get married at the age of 24, how much it is probable that you will follow my advice? See, we don't see astrology in this aspect. We don't see it in this aspect. Either we already get married and if there is a problem, we go to the astrologer. Right? Or things go in the natural flow. We fall in love, we get married. Or also, even when you go to the astrologer, you are like, you know, you go for timing of the event, sir, when I will get married. I don't think that is it is the real use of astrology. When I will get married is not the stuff. When I should get married is the stuff. Are you getting my point? When I will get married is not the stuff. When I should get married is the stuff. So you actually should see which planet is negatively activated, which planet is positively activated. And then you decide it is the right time to do this or not. And everything, not talking about any specific thing, everything have a positive thing and have a negative thing, right? So of course, every planet will be negatively activated at a point of time and every planet will be positively activated at a point of time. That is pretty simple. But what you choose, marriage with the negative activation of Mars or marriage with the negative activation of Jupiter, even if Jupiter is negatively activated at the time of marriage, it will not create much problem rather than creating a problem in producing a child. So problem related to child will be there, but there will be no fights at all, right? So it depends on you what you are activating, right? It is always your free will, right? You choose to do something. So there are a lot of karma who are searching your address. You know, karma never loses an address. This is a Vedanta saying. Ki karma finds the person like a calf finds the cow. So there are 4 or 5 karmas which are just searching you, 4 or 5 marriage related karma that are just searching you. And you have the free will to choose one of them. And you chose it and rest is history. So what you choose is something. So this is the power of choice, you know, what I am choosing. See, nothing is good. Nothing is perfect. See, none of us have a perfect marriage. That is pretty simple. None of us have a perfect relationship. That is pretty simple. But choose your curse wisely. Choose your problem wisely. I am very satisfied with a marital life having no child versus a marital life having fight everyone or beating everyone. Though if it is a negative activation of sun at the time of marriage, it doesn't create a major problem. It is just the problem that there will be some, you know, distance with parents, specifically with father. That's okay. You can still choose to, you know, go into a new, shift into a new family and do it, right?